So yesterday, Evan and I debated, got very heated over the future of Pete Alonso with the Mets. And today, we get a piece in Fox Sports from Disha Thozar, who flat out asked Pete Alonso, are you toxic? An unnamed Met player. Why you wouldn't name yourself if there was no problem with toxicity, I don't know, says he's not a problem. So if that is the case, no problem here, then isn't Steve Cohen a bit of a problem? And Lugie, that is where we begin today.
When you say, is Steve Cohen a problem, can you please expand on that?
I'm going to expand on it. We are in a honeymoon phase with Steve Cohen.
Yes.
Steve Cohen is the king we were promised in New York.
Yes.
The Steinbrenners would no longer be the big kings of spending in New York.
The Mets will be the new evil empire. Steve Cohen will be Thanos. Yes, I got it.
Everything about it. And yet, we sit here with a year left remaining on the potentially biggest Mets homegrown star of our lifetime. And he is openly now, by national reporters, Ken Rosenthal namely, has been shopped pre-deadline with the belief he will continue to be shopped this offseason. And we have now sat here, Met fans, reporters, those in the locker room, because how dare you not be in the locker room and speculate, and shot down the idea that there's any sort of problem in the Met clubhouse. Well, if there's no sort of problem in the Met clubhouse, why on earth would you be shopping a guy based on money, if money is no object? If that is the case, then Steve Cohen is absolutely a fraud when it comes to the promises Met fans were given in terms of spending.
Hold on, that's a big word. If you're going to come out here and throw words like that around, call the guy a fraud.
Well, he has to be.
No. Because when it comes to money and it comes to Steve Cohen, who has a ton, who has unlimited,
right,
who's a billionaire, it doesn't mean he's going to spend money like a drunken sailor. We saw it with DeGrom. We saw it with Correa. He's not going to just spend for the sake of spending. So that comes down to Alonso.
Interesting.
Okay, hold on. When you have Alonso and you're going to give the guy the bag and whatever they want, whether it be 7, 8, 9, 10 years, and you have a guy that at the back end of that contract is not going to look good, the Mets are allowed to have pause with that. Now, if Alonso next year hits 90 home runs, Steve Cohen is going to have to pony up. We know that, just like the Yankees did with Judge. But this idea that you're calling him a fraud because they brought up money, he still has to spend the money wisely. Because you could argue going into this year, and quite frankly, the proof is in the pudding, they did not spend money wisely. They had to backtrack.
No doubt.
Shaun, they're paying guys like Scherzer and Verlander to play elsewhere. Paying them to play elsewhere. Money is not an issue with this guy. So
well,
you can't call him a fraud.
No, I can, Tommy. And look, you could say that he needs to spend money wisely, and there's no denying that. Just because you have money doesn't mean you should just completely throw it away and outbid yourself. The worst thing you could do in sports is outbid yourself. But if Pete Alonso was a year away from free agency, and we were hearing trade rumors, and he was on another team, and he's the Pete Alonso statistically that we know, every Met fan would be calling this station and saying, hey, Steve Cohen, nobody could outbid you. You need to go trade for Pete Alonso and make sure you lock him up after. Yet Pete Alonso is coming from that locker room right now, and he is open. Again, this is not, hey, do you think the Mets are having these conversations? You have reporters, respected reporters like Ken Rosenthal, saying flat out, they came close to trading him to Milwaukee. The Yankees just went through this with Aaron Judge. At no point a year out was Aaron Judge discussed in trade rumors.
Hold on. I got to push back on one quick thing here because I think it's important to clarify this. When you say the Mets shopped him, I don't know if that's necessarily accurate. Is it Milwaukee inquired about him? There's a difference between telling all the teams, we are trading Pete, we're shopping him, and a team or two inquiring and doing their due diligence at the deadline. Go ahead.
Is there denial? Are we denying that there's enough smoke right now that the Mets are at least entertaining the idea of trading Pete Alonso?
They are entertaining it.
If you are an owner that other owners fear will outspend anybody, wouldn't you think that playing nice with your star homegrown first baseman, letting him play out the contract, even if you're saying, I'm not going to write you the check you're asking for right now in negotiations, I will tell you, go to free agency in another year and then come back to me with the best offer you have, and I guarantee we will beat it. That is smart business. That is absolutely what the Mets should be doing. They are not doing that. They are entertaining the idea of trading Pete Alonso. That is not even deniable. So, again, I come back to this report now from from Deisha in Fox Sports. Why? Why is money now an issue that trades would be discussed? You don't have to write him a blank check. You could go battle it out in another year with free agency. I asked Evan yesterday, flat out, well, why don't you just get something back and then go bid on him in a year? And he said, well, then you lose the track. You might anger him, something like that.
Well, he could fall in love with the place he's in, too, and he can never come back.
Well, you should be signing him now if you're Steve Cohen and you were promised to us that we are going to go keep everybody that's a star or go sign anybody that's a star. If Pete Alonso wasn't a Met, you'd want Steve Cohen going after
him. Well, hold on a second. He never promised he's going to sign every single star.
Well, he should be the one that makes the decision whether he's going to outbid any other team for him, correct?
Yeah, and yes. But here's the thing, too, with Cohen, and you're alluding to it. You're getting close to the line. I'm going to go over the line here. Steve Cohen, and I think this is what you love about Steve Cohen. This is what I love about Steve Cohen as a Met fan. He is a Met fan.
Yep.
He is also very much plugged in. He is very much plugged in on a social media site that we're not allowed to talk about that used to be a bird and now is a letter. He understands, and he has the temperature of the Met fans. Met fans are not happy and will be furious if they trade Pete Alonso for several reasons. Number one, he's a talented player. Number two, we love him. Number three, we romanticize the idea about having a lifelong Met because we haven't had that many. So, if he does this, there is going to be a major outcry. And like you alluded to, there has been a honeymoon period here with Steve Cohen.
Absolutely.
This will be the first time, and I'm talking to you Met fans out here, where if Steve Cohen trades him, because you sure as hell have thrown a lot of shade at Sal, you've thrown shade at Morash, heck, I've even caught a few strays. You've gotten mad at us. Will you get mad at the owner if he trades Pete Alonso, the beloved Pete Alonso? That's where you have to be fair, because then you can't kiss his ass if he does.
Now, I want to go back to this report that came out today. And if you haven't read it, it's on foxsports.com. And it's a lot of quotes from Pete Alonso saying he's never heard of the person that speculated he was toxic. I know he's talking about a Sal Licata, our friend on the Midday Show. The other problem with this report, and frankly, I think a problem with society today, and we are so like short-fused with this, Tommy, that we pick and choose what we want to hear out of arguments and not the whole argument.
I agree with you.
There is not a soul on this radio station, Sal, whether it was me in the discussion with Evan yesterday, that said flat out, we know that Pete Alonso is a toxic person in the clubhouse.
Mm-hmm.
What has been speculated is that the Met clubhouse itself has been toxic, and Pete Alonso is part of that core that features Nimmo, McNeil, Lindor, you know all these big names that are inside that clubhouse.
And Edwin Diaz.
Yeah. And the only one with a year left on his deal that could be moved to change the feel inside that locker room. Every Met fan, of course, if I was a Met fan, I wouldn't want to move Pete Alonso. But if there is a problem in the locker room, Pete Alonso could be right in any squabble that exists in that locker room. It doesn't make him the problem. It makes him the movable piece if there is a problem in the locker room. So flat out asking Pete Alonso if he's toxic is not actually listening to what has been discussed as we try to follow the breadcrumbs here on WFAN on a daily basis. Now, that being said, again, if you are a Met fan that is stuck in the mud and refuses, closes your eyes, closes the blinds, and say there is no problem in this locker room, whether it's Alonso v. Lindor or anything like that, then you can't at the same time say Steve Cohen is doing everything he promised us. One of two things is true. Either there is a problem in that locker room, or Steve Cohen is playing games right now where we thought there would be no games played as far as getting rid of stars when you should be the team outbidding everybody.
Well, they did.
And if Steve Cohen, I'm going to hammer one more point on this again. If Steve Cohen doesn't want to write him a blank check, I get it. Then you also can't be trading him. You need to play the Aaron Judge game that the Yankees did with their idiot GM and turned out to be right, and they paid the most money.
Yeah, they're definitely playing games, and it's now being played out publicly. This has now gotten ugly. It's only going to get uglier because I don't think that they're going to sign him in the offseason. They're not going to extend him or give him a big contract. So they're going to trade him, or this is going to be hanging over the team's head next year. The issue here is, and Shaun, you said, well, why do people react this way? Because fans are emotional, and Met fans feel an emotional attachment to Pete. Met fans do not want to hear that there are any problems. Met fans want to think everything is rosy.
No doubt.
Here's the problem. When it comes to reports, when it comes to things like this, number one, there's two sides to every single story. If you ask every single person in that locker room, maybe. But if you only ask people, and I think it speaks to the potential, and it's just a hunch because I've had a hunch, that there's a divide in the locker room. If there are Team Alonso or people that are pro-Pete, of course, they're going to say, we love Pete. He's the best. He's a leader. We want him here for life. But if there are people that are against Pete, maybe you don't talk to them or maybe whatever. So if there's a divide, that's where you have the problem.
And this is the only reason I would be skeptical of the piece. And again, if we are to believe everything that is written to be true in this piece today, if we are to believe that, then I'm sorry. Steve Cohen right now is flirting with disaster.
Oh, I believe everything's true. I just think this, Shaun. Hold on. I think this. When you have a locker room, when you are on a movie set, when you are in a band, when you are in a wrestling locker room, if you are at a sports talk radio station, I barely like Shaun. In fact, I hate his guts. There are people there that don't like each other. I'm sorry. You have grown men that are around each other all the time. You got a wife, you got a husband, you got kids. You like them all the time? Of course not. It's part of this. So this idea that there could be no shot that there are issues in a clubhouse is ridiculous. I understand having an emotional reaction to it. I am a Met fan. It would bother me. I understand where it would bother you. But this idea that you would just shush it off and say, yeah, no shot. You're just looking for a reason. Come on. Open your eyes a little bit. Stuff like this happens all the time across all platforms of entertainment.
And that's why it is okay to be skeptical when you read this piece because of a couple things. Number one, it's a lot of quotes from Alonso. It does come across as a bit of an Alonso puff piece, no doubt. And you took quotes from Max Scherzer, who, why is Max Scherzer going to stick his nose out?
Well, also, because they asked him when he was here.
Of course. And also, when Max Scherzer answered that, it was very evident he was talking about him and Verlander. He wasn't getting into the other stuff.
Yes,
that was the way it was interpreted.
Yep.
And the only other quote we got was from an unnamed Met player. Now, if Pete Alonso and the Mets clubhouse had no problem, Pete Alonso was like this great leader, why would the player be unnamed? Why would you be afraid to not name yourself?
Yeah.
Why? I mean, it's not a bad report. You're saying something positive about your first baseman.
That's fair.
That's a little skeptical, too.
That's fair. I mean, you see that a lot, unnamed or whatever.
Unnamed usually when it involves something negative, but this is defending your teammate. You're unnamed. Why would you be unnamed if you had to defend your teammate?
Oh, listen, I think there's probably a divide. I mean, again, but it's a hunch.
It's just
speculation. Oh, and by the way, as hosts, as WFAN, we're allowed to speculate. We're allowed to have hunches. We're not reporters. Now, maybe we have inside information. Maybe we have sources. And then a lot of times we do. Like, you don't think Sal has sources? Of course he does. But we're also allowed to have hunches and speculation. And we're allowed to see things through the eyes of not just fans, but also people that talk on the radio.
There are breadcrumbs about it, 877-337-6666. They ain't leading the chicken cutlet making either. Either Steve Cohen is about to be a fraud, or Pete Alonso in that locker room, there is some sort of problem. Juan is in Bergen. Juan, you're on Evan and Tiki. What's up, man?
Hey, how you doing, guys?
What's up, Juan?
So I was trying to call you guys yesterday, and I couldn't get through. But yesterday, I wholeheartedly disagreed with Morash, respectfully. And today, I tend to agree with you more. I'm going to tell you why. I'm one of the stupid idiots who still watch these Met games. I don't know why, but I do. I'm just a
Because you're a fan of the team, Juan. That's why. Don't call yourself a stupid idiot. You love the Mets and you want to watch them. Now, I would suggest but you're not a stupid idiot.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Yes.
But, and so, with that said, I don't believe... And I could be wrong. I don't believe at all that Pete Alonso's a cancer, and I'm going to tell you why. Because Pete Alonso has been nothing but a model citizen for the Mets.
You're right.
You know, he was interviewed recently in the locker room after a game, and they asked him how he felt about, about him getting traded, being on a block during the trade deadline. And he reiterated and said, I want to be a Met for the rest of my life. I love this organization. I love this city.
Which is what you want to hear.
Exactly. So for this guy to be a cancer, he's not the third baseman that the Yankees...
Well, no one's used that word, Juan. No one said he's a cancer.
You know, for everybody to say he's a cancer or whatever...
Nobody said that.
Juan, this is the problem. Juan, thank you for the call. This is the problem. I'm still waiting for the first person that has openly declared that Pete Alonso's a cancer. Well, what has been said is... there is some kind of toxicity divide in the locker room. And start doing the math on baseball contracts. Is Francisco Lindor getting traded with his deal?
Nope.
Is Brandon Nimmo getting traded with the fresh deal he has?
And by the way, on
Jeff
Lindor...
Jeff McNeil, probably not.
No, and by the way, on Lindor, because he does get a lot of crap, Lindor has been a very good man.
Right.
I understand he had that issue with Baez right out of the gate. You never go against the fans. You always lose. He's learned from that. He's been their best hitter all season. I like Lindor. To expand on this point here, Shaun, if there is a problem in the locker room, Pete Alonso is in that locker room. If there is a problem in that locker room,
huge
and you're
part.
Trying to fix it, You look at a guy like Alonso, it's nothing necessarily against Pete. It doesn't mean Steve Cohen doesn't like Pete Alonso.
Right.
It doesn't mean they don't value him.
Pete could be at its core right in any single squabble that he might have had in the locker room.
Right, but he's the guy you could move on from
and get
in
return.
The hope to get a big return and to fix the problem.
Right.
That's the part that I don't think people are grasping, Shaun, because there is an emotional attachment to Alonso, and Met fans are acting emotionally
when they
see and hear stuff like this, and they're drawing conclusions, and they're not listening to what people are saying, right?
No, they're
because they're reacting emotionally.
That's why I bring up the Cohen piece to start, because I think Steve Cohen has been a very beloved Met figure because his last name isn't Wilpon, and he was one of you, a Met fan, that could spend this money. Pete Alonso is your homegrown superstar first baseman, winning home run derbies and everything. At some point, we are on a collision course between these two figures here. There has been enough now out there speculated about where, as a Met fan, you're going to have to come to grips with you're not going to like something about one of these guys. And whether it ends up being Alonso was some kind of, you know, dysfunctional figure with other guys in that clubhouse, or Cohen isn't the endless pocket guy. One of those things is going to come to a head here. Because if it wasn't, then I don't think that this is a big deal, and I don't think the Mets should even be shopping Pete Alonso right now.
Well, but Shaun, we've already seen Steve Cohen be careful with the way he spends money, with DeGrom, with Correa. So I don't think it's a money thing. The money is there.
Well, that's what was in the report, that it's a money thing, right?
No, well, here's why. Because they don't necessarily have to back up the truck for Alonso.
Right.
I don't know what he's asking for, but let's just speculate. It's like 10 years for a ton of money. They may not think the player is worth that at the back end. That doesn't mean that Steve Cohen doesn't have money. It just means he wants to allocate his money, by the way, to a different player or a different direction.
Then wouldn't you assume that the money that Pete Alonso's asking for and the years he's asking for probably wouldn't be given out by another team and that you could top anything? Shouldn't you at least let Pete Alonso get the free agency in a year without trading him and ticking him off and then making that determination?
Yeah, I mean, look, I don't think that Pete's ticked off. I think Pete wants to be here. Pete wants to... You know the deal here, dude. This has a lot to do with Pete's camp. This has to do with Steve Cohen. I'm sure Pete doesn't want anything to do with any of this stuff. I do believe he loves the Mets. I do believe he loves the Met fans. I think he loves New York. I don't think he's fraudulent anyway. Do I think he could be a little over the top with stuff like the home run derby? Sure, fine. It's easy to make fun of him for stuff like that. He takes it seriously. Guess what? It's a national stage. It's a Met player. We get that shine. I like that. I think Pete really wants to be here. This is the ugly side of business, and it is now being played out publicly, which I'm sure Pete himself hates.
Nick in Huntington. Nick, you're on the Fan.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
What's up, Nick?
I think the Mets are only entertaining Pete because he's the only member of the core that has a short-term deal. Now, Shaun, you said before the best business plan would be to let him play out his contract and then see what he gets in free agency and bring it back. I think the best business plan would be to trade him and then sign him in free agency, so at least you get some prospects, and then you can get him back.
I brought that up to Evan yesterday. If you could talk to Pete and say, hey, Pete, listen, we're not going to win next year, or we don't think we're going to win a World Series next year. We would like to have you long term. Look at what we could get back for you. Then you come back. I promise you that nobody's going to
top you.
Oh, what?
They're going to pinky swear on it? I know the Yankees did this with Chapman, but you run a risk that Alonso gets a little ticked off, loves the place he's in, and doesn't want to come back here.
But it's
a dangerous game.
But it's very clear you're going to allow him to go free anyway because you have no interest in signing him right now. So if you're letting
him
go
free
anyway.
Right now, no interest. Right now. We don't know about in a year from now. Right now. And they don't have to sign him right now. They don't have to do this.
They don't have to trade him right now, and they're openly talking about it.
And I'm sure they're furious that this has come out. They didn't want this to come out because I'm sure they're trying to be shrewd businessmen with a beloved Met. And again, Steve Cohen has his ear to the ground. He understands that. He sure as hell, if he didn't understand it a month ago, he sure as hell understands it right now, Nick.
Yeah, and it seems like something Steve Cohen would do. He always seems like he's like a business savvy guy. This seems like, you know, and another note. Didn't Jalen Hyatt cook sauce the other day? Why is these posts on Twitter saying that
Nick,
sauce? You know,
Nick, it's I'm starting. And look, we're gonna get to the Jets in a little bit, and you saw some of this on Hard Knocks. I don't know if the words "feel bad" is starting to come into tuition for some of the like the Jet nonsense. We'll get to it later. Hyatt didn't catch a ball. He wasn't playing with Daniel Jones. That's a win that forget anti-Jet Giant fan should be excited about. Sauce Gardner is the greatest, best corner in football. You saw him beat him by multiple steps. With a real starting quarterback in there and an offensive line, he beats him for a touchdown.
But exactly. It's impossible to judge that
Giant
game when
fans,
you have starters versus backups.
I will not ignore. I know Giant fans are all revved up. We will not ignore you later. I promise we'll get into plenty of football and Hard Knocks as well.